school two-prong socket. I think I'm gonna have to potentially dump the canister before I even get done with this one room. Canister from this place, big time. And the first time that I felt like I should wipe the cord down with a damp towel, and look at that, stuff came off of it. I'm gonna be cleaning this vacuum from bottom up. So this one's got a lot of cat urine in it, so I don't know if you guys could tell in the video when I was vacuuming, but I mean, yeah, pretty bad. So I'm gonna be cleaning this all out big time before I do another job, no doubt. But I wanted to show you guys this and the fact that I got some stuff on the cable off when I wiped it as I put it back up. Crazy. Probably in my top three worst pet urine jobs. I actually suggested that it gets replaced because this room is pretty much been hit everywhere, and it's old carpet, worn, torn, all of that. This is the scrub the carpet, helps massage the pre-spray in and loosen the soils. No. Yeah. Not at all. Just relax outside and you're good. surprised there isn't any more kick out yet. But this is why I do spray out the brushes and the undercarriage of the CRV after jobs, because it needs to be cleaned and sanitized after stuff like this, especially jobs like this. So this room is definitely the worst. As soon as I walked into basically the kitchen area right next to this room, you can smell it. And again, I did suggest replacement, but for the situation, she just would like to have it cleaned. Because there is actual missing damaged carpet in the bedroom. So this is the only room that I'm doing pet treatment product on, just for financial reasons. She wanted to keep it at a certain cost, so I took that into account, and also mentioned, well, this is the room that probably has the most spots in it, so let's go ahead and take care of it. And then I'll be using an enzyme cleaner for the rest, and also this room, but I pre-sprayed the bedroom and the front room with an enzyme cleaner, so it will help. And then I did use a scoop of my Pure O2 from Truck Mount Forums, which is an odor and stain remover as well, but I did not use Unchained as per request of the client, but I did in here quite strong. Basically no dilution, just poured it in my Hydroforce / pre-sprayer with no water added. Was actually laying up against this dresser, and because it wasn't very heavy, I put it back down and cleaned this side. Definitely a tear out and put new carpet in, but like I said, this is just a situation. I'm trying to clean it and get it presentable for her. But with this much soil and pet urine, the soil can easily be also in the pad and underneath it. Like if you've ever had an area rug on your hard surface and it's been there for a year or so, and you pick it up, you see all that fine dust and stuff underneath it. Same thing happens with your carpets. So regular vacuuming is a must to minimize that, because your carpet can actually re-soil faster if it gets really bad. And it's definitely not something that the carpet cleaner can completely get rid of, because it's beneath the carpet. So you'd have to pull the carpet and pad back and vacuum the subfloor. I've actually had to do that before. Did it at my old house when we put new floors in. There's some little areas basically in front of where like the couches were sitting that had a little bit of dust and dirt hanging out right there. Alright guys, let's see what kind of water we got going so far. Ooh. Nice and brown. And the color's probably been diluted because of all the pee that I've been getting out. It's crazy though. Solid brown. Alright everybody, second job of the day up in Sonora, California. Still up in the hills a little bit. This is a repeat client of mine. I've actually claimed for her, I think, twice when I worked for another company. And now this will be my third time as my own company. Very grateful that she decided to use me and not continue to use the big company, that she liked how I performed the work. It's very kind of her. So it's just this living room and some carpet in the master bedroom. Not much. So it's just a small job. This carpet's in here, probably at least 10 plus years old. Because I think the first time I cleaned it was probably 8 years ago. Somewhere around there. I had to clean everything thoroughly. It was bad, guys. Sorry I couldn't show even more of it, because that one put me behind. This house is about an hour away from where I was, and I just got here about 15 minutes ago, and at the end of my normal time commitment. And I still gotta go back down into Riverbank and give somebody an estimate. And I had to move that one back a little bit too, so I can make sure I have plenty of time to take care of this client. The next one is just an estimate, so I want to make sure I have plenty of time for my actual cleaning clients. And the other one was very flexible, so. Carpet in here. This is flush carpet in the living room.